long time, no chat on camera. Mike's Jackadoo boy, so they say. Nice to see everyone again. Like I said in the previous video, I think I've been quite busy moving old stuff onto the new site. With that said, hope everybody's keeping well. I hope this information is useful to you. That's what it's about, isn't it? It's about using the information. If you don't use it, if you don't try the things I say, so be it. There's an alternative system there, isn't there? It's not the system I use, see. I don't follow it one bit because I disagree with it entirely. That's the idea of the channel. The channel was never meant to be the British Art Foundation. How could it ever be them? You know, they're a faceless entity, aren't they? They claim to be the experts on your art and know everything. But there's so many, you know, at the end of the day, it's just a massive, massive money-making thing again. They've turned it into a business. They've turned art disease, which is a disease you get from abusing your arterioles, isn't it? Basically, you know. So it's a lifestyle disease. Heart disease is a lifestyle disease. And you can still be grateful for surgery. I mean, surgery is a great thing. You can always be grateful for that. And this channel was never designed to knock surgery, because I truly, it plays such an important part in keeping people alive. So you just can't dismiss surgery. But some of the drugs used to treat heart patients, obviously, they are absolutely loaded with problems. And I spoke on many times about statins, and I spoke about amiodarone in particular in my own experiences. And there you have it. You can only talk from experience. And anyway, you're not going to get, you know, you're not going to get all that stuff on this channel. It's not designed for that. It's the alternative. This is the alternative to everything the British Art Foundation tell you what to do. Because for me, like I say, who are they to say they're the experts? Now, I'm not saying the surgeons are not great at what they do, but my recovery has been very different from the people I see and the people I hear talk. And I have a very different tale to tell on my recovery, and it's one that should be told, because it's very, very different in the whole approach and everything. So I do hope you'll join me and watch more videos, because they all revolve around recovery and recovering an art, and seeing just what you're capable of on very finite limits. You know, hence there's a video out now about getting electrocuted and what it's like, you know, when you get shocked. Excuse me. So I hope you'll stick around for the ins and outs. And like I say, my recovery has been a lot different from what I hear people doing, you know. And my recovery has been cycling and exercise focused, and also mind focused. And I've addressed all that. Not taking drugs. And one of the first things I did was get rid of the drugs. So this is nothing to do with, you know, I was on all the drugs, I came off all the drugs. So this is, you know, I will point out to you the shortcomings and the shortfall of the drugs. Well, all drugs leach minerals in your urine, so that's a problem with all drugs. It's one of them problems that they've had from the very, very early days, that all minerals rise, attach themselves to drugs. You know, drugs pull minerals out, they leach minerals out the body. And people who use drugs on a regular basis are more prone to get bone issues, and that is a fact. So how can you have a proper recovery and make energy through the systems? You can't make energy through the systems of the bacteria and the B vitamins. When you're throwing the minerals away, you can't do it. So you do. It was a no-brainer for me to just walk away from all the drugs, because I was already experiencing side effects, hence the blue nose and hence the amiodarone video. I was already experiencing, I've had all the side effects. That was the last thing I needed. That was the last thing I needed. You've got to recover. That's what you're looking to do, to recover. Not throw your sodden minerals down the drain and down the pan. And when you start researching, you quickly realise you do just that when you use drugs. That's why drug therapy is for. And like I say, again, how can you have a drug? How can you have such a thing as a statin drug that's going to lower cholesterol? And the very cholesterol you need to make this male a male, because you need cholesterol to make progesterone, and from progesterone, testosterone comes. So you're going to alter the male hormones, you're going to alter the female hormones. And like I've said many times, how can you have a drug that works through your liver to block cholesterol, because it's such an important, almost like hormone in your body, isn't it? It's such a building block needed for so many things, even glial cells in your brain and synapse activations. I mean, you can't restrict that on the acetyl-CoA reductase system. If you're messing with that system, and it's a 16-chain system, right, highly reliant on enzymatic actions, and it blocks coenzyme Q10, and I have done a video on it, and I have spoke about it, and it's there in your face. It blocks coenzyme Q10. So when you're blocking coenzyme Q10, you're going to be low on antioxidants, and you're certainly going to be down on energy, because coenzyme Q10, ubiquinolone, ubiquinone, must be utilised to make energy. You know, it's an energy production system that you're messing with to alter the cholesterol system. And for me, like I said, and like I can explain, it's fraudulent system to sell drugs, you know. And like I joke about it, and I seriously mean it, because I study, and that's what I study, you know. I study health, side effects, interactions, all that kind of stuff, and exercise, of course. And that's what I study, and I spend all my time studying it. And I can tell you, right, the cholesterol theory is a complete and utter myth. It makes lots of people lots of money. It certainly does, you know. And once you realise how it does work, you quickly realise it's a scam. So for me, I wanted something that worked, not a load of bullshit. It drew energy off me and away from me. For some, you know, God particle, God given. And you almost like these guys are telling you that God made a mistake, did he? Did God actually make a mistake, you know, with cholesterol? And some guy in a white coat is telling me that. Because, mate, you've got to be fucking joking. The guy who created all this made such a good job of it. Oh yeah. Oh, what a job he made of it. And then some guy in a white coat, you know. He doesn't make mistakes. The people who make drugs make mistakes and bury it and hide it. Okay, God very rarely makes mistakes. It's the people who vaccinate and make drugs, right, and put those mistakes there and deny it. Yeah, and think they're better than God. Amazing, you know. But still, different systems, you know, with that said, I went about with a completely different system of training, one which was directed at the heart and lungs and the diaphragm. So I wanted to make the diaphragm stronger for a start, so I did lots of pullovers with weights, with discs. Doing a video on a pullover, I suppose, yeah, why not? And I wanted to get more oxygen uptake for obvious reasons, like I say, for the fact that your heart cells are capable of hibernation and you don't realise it and you're not told it, but they are capable of that. And if only you know that, you think about it, and just thinking about it is likely to activate that mechanism when you require it. So if you're told, which I don't know why you haven't been, and there aren't many people who even heard of this, that's heart hibernation. The cells are capable of deciding, now I've done a video on it guys, they're deciding whether to hang on for a new oxygen supply. And that's called collateral, you know, differentiation, where the oxygen supply can be made by the arterioles, and then the heart cell will regenerate, will not turn to scar tissue, will not scar up, yeah. I believe this system is a speciality of the heart muscle, so it's a special trick up its sleeve, and it's amazing if you think about it. So now you know about it, does it make a difference? Of course it does, because I've just implanted that information in your mind. And as long as you know that, if you should ever succumb to a problem, or if you're going through that very problem now and trying to recover, just remember what I've just told you. You could well be in hibernation, and if you influence it at just the right time, it makes a massive, massive difference. And while you're not told this, I do not know for the life of me. But, once I knew about it, once I came across that research, I was onto it, and I wanted to prove it. I wanted to disprove that research, and I've proven that research very true, I think. Something very true that you should know about. You know, I came across it, and wow, did I have to experiment with that. And that's how a lot of the training was based around, so proving that research was it gives you something to aim for and something to hope for. If you don't know about it, you can't put your mind to it. And where the mind goes, the energy flows. Okay, where the mind goes, the energy flows. So if you don't know about that, you can't add your energy to it, can you?